Ever wondered how mirrors, an everyday object in our lives, are made? The story begins with the Venetians, who invented mirrors and guarded the process for nearly a century. It wasn't until industrial espionage in the late 16th century that the secret was unveiled. Now that you know the secret history of mirrors, let's delve into how they are actually made. The main component of mirrors is glass. But did you know it's a poor reflector by itself? That's right. Glass only reflects around 4% of light. But don't worry, we've got a trick up our sleeve to solve that. But first, let's talk about how we get our glass. Glass sheets are primarily made from silica. This can be obtained from refined or mined sand. Sand, of all things. But it's not just any sand, it's a special type that's rich in silica. There's also synthetic glass, made from synthetic fused silica. This is a man-made material, produced under controlled conditions. So we've got our glass, and now it's ready to become something more. Now that we have our glass, it's time to prepare it for the reflective coating. Before we can turn our glass into a mirror, it needs a good cleaning. So our glass sheets are transported to a washing station. Here, they are meticulously cleaned using a combination of water and cerium oxide powder. This isn't your average household cleaning, folks. The cerium oxide powder acts as a gentle abrasive, dislodging any stubborn impurities and oils that may have found a home on the glass surface. Now, to ensure we get every nook and cranny, rotating brushes come into play. These brushes scrub and polish both surfaces of the glass, leaving us with a surface that's as clean and smooth as a whistle. With our glass cleaned and prepped, we can now add the reflective coating. The magic happens when we add the reflective coating to the glass. To start, the glass is sprayed with hot demineralized water. This step is crucial to prevent any damage from tap water minerals. Once the glass is prepped, it's time for the tin. Liquefied tin is carefully applied to the back of the glass, acting as a base for the next step, silvering. Liquid silver is then applied, and this is where things get reflective. The silver reacts with the tin, creating a shiny, mirror-like surface. However, in our modern times, we often use aluminum instead of silver. Why, you ask? Well, aluminum not only offers high reflectance, but it's also readily available. Now that our glass is reflective, it needs to be protected. Our mirror is almost complete, but it needs a little protection first. To start, we rinse off the excess silver. Then, we turn to the task of painting. Not just one, but two layers of paint are applied to shield the reflective surface. But that's not all. For extra armor, we introduce a layer of copper. This copper layer is an added barrier against corrosion and damage. But we're not quite done yet. Any excess copper is rinsed off before we put the glass to dry. Once dry, a second coat of paint, this time of a different color, is applied. The glass is then cured at a higher temperature, hardening the paint and creating a robust, protective shell. With our mirror protected, it's time for the final steps. Quality control is crucial in the mirror-making process. At this stage, the glass panel undergoes a thorough inspection. Any imperfections or faults on the surface are meticulously identified and corrected. This ensures that the mirror provides an accurate and flawless reflection. But we're not done yet. An acid wash is applied next, its purpose being to eliminate any unwanted metal residue that might have lingered from the previous steps. And finally, the mirror is cut into the desired shape. This is done using a specialized saw with diamond dust embedded in the tips, allowing for precise and clean cuts. And voila, our mirror is now ready for the world. From the manufacturing plant, our mirror is ready to be shipped worldwide. After passing rigorous quality control checks, the mirrors are carefully packed to prevent any damage during transit. Various protective measures are employed, such as bubble wrap or foam padding, and often the mirrors are crated for additional security. Depending on the destination, they may be shipped via land, air, or sea. Regardless of the method, the goal is the same: to ensure that each mirror reaches its destination in perfect condition, ready to reflect the world back to its new owner. And that's how a simple piece of glass is transformed into a mirror. What else would you like to learn about? Leave your suggestions in the comments below.